What do rainbows and echoes have in common? If you think about it, they actually have a lot in common. They're both kind of awe-inspiring. When you see a rainbow, you stop and you look. When you hear an echo, you usually stop and shout to experience the echo again and again. What's going on here? Well, they're both waves interacting with the world around them. Rainbows are light interacting with water, and echoes are sound waves interacting with the objects in the world around us, maybe a mountain or a valley, echoing back to us. It turns out that we can understand these processes using science, and that actually doesn't make them less awe-inspiring. The fact that rainbows and echoes feel sort of magical doesn't mean they're not also scientific. They're not mutually exclusive categories. In fact, as we understand these waves better, we can wonder even more at echoes and rainbows. Let's learn all about waves and their interactions with the world. Let's get started by reviewing our lesson objectives. First, we'll introduce wave interference. Then we'll explain wave reflection. And lastly, we'll examine wave refraction. Sounds fancy. Okay, first up, interference. To understand interference, we need to start by just looking at one circular wave. Here we've dropped a stone in water, and it creates this nice, neat, circular pattern. But something interesting happens when we drop two stones nearby. So we've dropped one stone in the center here, and that created one circular wave, and another stone here, and that created another circular wave. Okay, well, where these two waves overlap, we see sort of a new choppy behavior emerge. The wave looks different there. The reason the wave looks different there is because of interference. Those two waves are overlapping. Compare that to the bottom of that second circular wave, and we don't see any of that strange behavior because there's no overlap between the waves. That's just one wave by itself, while the middle is two waves overlapping. What that means then is that when we don't have overlap, we don't have any interaction. But when we do have overlap, we get an interaction. Overlapping waves interact. This interaction is called interference. Let's watch this interference in real time. You have to pay very close attention as these circles of waves overlap, creating a more intricate and choppy pattern. Do you see it? Pay attention the next time you're at a body of water, especially if you have a really still body of water. Drop two stones near each other and watch for this interference. Here we can picture interference much more neatly. We have two waves adding together. The red is overlapping with the red and the blue with the blue. In other words, the peaks overlapping with the peak and the troughs with the troughs. When they add together, we get a bigger wave. We call this constructive interference. That's when two waves combine to form a larger wave. And that's the opposite of what we see here. Now we have the blue overlapping with the red, and the red overlapping with the blue. In other words, the peaks and troughs are overlapping, and so they cancel out. This is destructive interference. That's when two waves combine to form a smaller wave, or just to get rid of the wave entirely. So waves can interfere with each other. That's the first important way waves interact. But waves can also be reflected. Let me give you an example. Echoes. So here this woman is screaming or yelling, and she hears the sound come back. That's an echo. Echoes are reflected sound waves. So if we picture what the waves are doing, we can imagine a speaker or a person. We've labeled it here the sender of the sound wave. And in the green, we have the original wave, and it travels out. It hits some object in the distance. Maybe it's a cliff or a valley, and it bounces off. And in pink, we see the reflected wave, the echo. Well, there are other important examples of a reflected wave. Here we see light waves being reflected. Light is traveling from, say, that white van behind us, hitting our side view mirror, bouncing off, or reflecting, and hitting our eyes. So mirrors reflect light waves. We've said that waves can interfere with each other, like when multiple waves interact. We've said that waves can be reflected, like when they bounce off an object. But waves can also be refracted. Waves can be refracted. What does that mean? Well, take a look at this pencil. We know the pencil's straight, but it almost looks like it's been chopped in half there in the middle. What's going on? This is an optical illusion. As the light travels from the pencil through the water and glass and out into the air, it's bent. So light exiting the glass is bent. And whenever light or any other wave is bent, we call it refraction. It's when a wave bends. To understand why waves bend, let's take a look at a kayak. Okay, so here this kayak is actually turning, or we might even say bending. How is that happening? Well, we're paddling on one side of the kayak, and so that side moves a little faster. On the other side, we're not paddling, and so that side moves a little slower. So which direction will the kayak turn? Well, it's going to turn towards the left, towards the slower side. And that's true for waves as well. Things turn toward the slower side. And here's the thing. The speed of light depends on the material. So it turns out that light travels slower in the glass than it does in the air. And that's what's causing this bend here. It turns out also that the speed of light depends on color. So that means some colors of light in some materials travel faster than others. And that actually gives rise to something we observe all the time. Let's take a look. Here's the sunlight emitting white light. The white light goes into a rain droplet, and it bounces around and it's bent. When it comes out, though, we have all the different colors. Why is this? Well, it's because different colors turn out to move at different speeds and bend different amounts. This bending of different colors at different angles gives rise to the rainbow. Pretty epic. So different colors of light bend differently. All right, let's review what we've learned. Let's match the descriptions with the best word from the lesson. So pause the video and see if you can correctly identify what word should go with each of these options. All right, let's review the answers. For A, it says two waves combine to make a larger wave. Well, when two waves combine, they're interfering. And because it's making a larger wave, that's constructive interference. B, an echo is an example of this. Well, that's reflection. The sound wave is reflecting. The bending of a wave is called this. That's refraction. Again, if you want to answer in a Jeopardy format and say what is refraction, that would be totally fine. D, rainbows are the result of this. Refraction, the bending of light, specifically the fact that different colors light bend different amounts. Okay, E, two waves combine and become smaller. That's destructive interference. Two waves are overlapping, and the fact that they become smaller means it's destructive. Let's review what we've learned. First, we introduced wave interference, where we saw that multiple waves overlapping gives rise to constructive and destructive interference. Then we explained wave reflection, like in echoes or in mirrors, waves can bounce off of things. And lastly, we examined wave refraction. That's when waves bend, and we said they do that because of the different speeds they travel in different mediums. Hey, hey.